let's get the bottom line with CNN political analyst and legendary Watergate journalist Carl Bernstein. And Carl, pretty fitting that we have you on this morning. Obviously, the Nixon tapes were part of the ultimate demise of the Nixon presidency. But you say the tape that we heard this weekend from President Trump calling the Georgia Secretary of State, asking him to find 11,870 votes or 780 votes, you say it's even worse than the Nixon tapes. Why? What makes this so bad?
Because the President of the United States, we are listening in real time to the President propose that there be a conspiracy to steal the election for the presidency of the United States, a coup, whatever word we choose to use, a dangerously out of control, unstable President of the United States provoking a constitutional crisis. And it's no accident that the generals in particular and the Defense Department officials are aware and are now saying out loud that the incumbent President of the United States is the gravest threat to the national security of the United States that we have. This is unprecedented, it is extraordinary, and it is time for the Republican leadership and the Democratic leadership of the Senate and the House to demand that this President of the United States resign immediately. If this had happened, if this tape were released at any other moment in our history, except Donald Trump's presidency, I think it's a very certain thing that the resignation of the President of the United States immediately would be demanded, or he would be impeached and convicted in the Senate post-haste.
Carl, these former defense secretaries who have taken it upon themselves to band together to write a public letter to the American public, basically sounding a cautionary note that there's no role for the military in election results. I mean, they're not putting it in as fine a point on it as you are. They're not saying that the president is a danger to the American people, but they're doing this for some reason. And so
they know it.
Yeah, what do you think
they know
saying?
It even better. They know it even better than I, because they know more classified information than I know. But I do know this from some of those people's aides who have signed that letter, etc., people in the intelligence community, that there already has been something that Trump has done in the past few weeks that deeply, deeply troubled the intelligence community, the Joint Chiefs of Staff, the generals, some kind of provocative action somewhere in the world that he had to be talked down from instigating. Don't know exactly what it is. We can speculate on trouble areas, Iran, the South China Sea, others. Something happened. Look, it has been a known fact that those closest to President Trump in his presidency in the national security area, his chiefs of staff, all concluded years and months ago that he was the principal danger to the national security of the United States, not our foreign adversaries. We also have his niece telling us about his mental state. The same kind of picture of him we've gotten from his principal aides who have left his presidency, but you've heard now from a family member. We are looking at a dangerously unstable President of the United States, such as we've never had, including Nixon, in the final days of his presidency, attempting to create a constitutional crisis to somehow hold onto office in his desperation, to selfishly exercise those followers of him, of himself, to do something provocative, dangerous, perhaps violent. It's time for the leadership of the Republican Party, especially Senator McConnell, to say, enough, Mr. President, we will not support you in any way. This is the shame of the Republican Party, McConnell and his fellows in the Senate, particularly, who have enabled this president in his acts, unstable acts, dangerous acts, illegal acts, a criminal and a seditious president of the United States is what we hear on this tape, proposing to steal an election. And if McConnell, McCarthy in the House cannot say, Mr. President, you have to go, you have to cease and desist, it is the shame of the Republican Party forever.
Carl, we have about 30 seconds left. What are you most concerned about in the next 15 and a half days?
Everything. That the Republicans will not do what needs to be done, because that is the most effective thing that can be done to stop this president from his crazy utterings, actions. He needs to be told he needs to be told by the leadership of his party that they are going to restrain him in every manner and keep him from exercising his powers. And otherwise, he should leave office and they should demand it immediately.
Carl Bernstein, we always appreciate getting your take. Thank you very much.
Thank you.